What's up, everybody? Welcome to IGN Live from Gamescom. I'm Damon Hatfield. It's time to talk Scalebound. Hideki Kamiya is director. Welcome to the show. JP Callum is producer.
Hi, man.
And Kyoko Higo will be translating for us today.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's talk some Scalebound. This was unveiled at E3 last year, mm-hmm. and now a year and some change later, we've gotten our first look at gameplay mm-hmm. this year at Gamescom. So what is Scalebound? Let's start there.
Scalebound is, so desu ne, mazu sono居住同士 の, あの激しいバトルを、見てみたいっていうところから着想を得たゲームで、そこに僕が子供の頃から憧れていたファンタジーの世界を重ね合わせて、それでドラゴンと、青年という2人の、絆を描いていく、物語のゲームです。
So really at its core where it started out is that I really wanted to showcase and illustrate an area and environment、where you canSee these gigantic sort of creatures or monsters going at each other, fighting against each other, and just be struck by it in awe. And on top of that, I've always wanted to make a game based on a fantasy sort of setting. I love dragons. And on top of that, obviously, you know, how cool will it be if you can interact with the dragon, not just control or have the dragon as an enemy, but be engaged in it?
As I understand it, you specifically wanted to portray a dragon as a good guy. Is that correct?
ドラゴンはその敵ではなくて自分の味方、まあ、相方っていう立場ですよね。
そうですね。まあ、ご覧の通りドルーは、まあ、ドルーという青年は右腕がドラゴンのようになってますけども、それによってこう生命を共有する、関係になっていると。なので2人は、この世界で生き残るためには力を合わせなければならないという関係になっていて、まあ、そこからこう絆を深めていくというのが、ゲームのテーマになっています。
Yes, so、if you can see on Drew, his right arm has been transformed into what we're calling the dragon arm, and that symbolizes that、Drew and the dragon Tuban is sharing their life source, and what that means is that throughout the entire course of the game you are going to have to work together to overcome、the challenges and the obstacles along the way、
hmm. SoWhat is this world? Drew is a human from Earth, right? But we're not on Earth now. So can you sort of explain what's happening here?
ドリューはその我々の世界から、うん、
そうですね、まあ、我々の世界からこの世界に、まあ、行ってしまった青年なんですけども、なぜこの世界に行ってしまったかっていうのは、今はまだお話できないんですが、これから明らかにしていきます。で、この世界はドラコニスという、ファンタジーの世界で、まあ、そこにドルーは突然行ってしまうわけですけれども、そこで彼が、どのように生き抜いて、まあ、なぜこの世界に来てしまったのか、そういうことを冒険していくことが、ストーリーの核になると思います。
Yeah, you're right. Drew is、a young man from our Earth, from modern world Earth, and he's been transported to this world called Draconis. And why and how and all that is sort of still under wraps, but he is going to be、sort of mysteriouslyYou know, thrown into this world, trying to figure out what's going on. Why is he here? How am I supposed to survive? Who are you know, the allies and the enemies? And、he quickly, obviously, discovers that、Tuban the dragon is someone that he's going to have to partner up with and sort of rely on and build that trust.
So it looks like we're going to encounter a bunch of large-scale enemies in this game.
そうですね。巨大な敵ですよ。
そうですね。巨大な敵と戦うことがこのゲームのテーマなんですが。まあ、小型の敵も登場するので、まあ、小型の敵はドル、一人でも戦えるんですけども、これだけ巨大な敵になってくると、ドル一人の力ではかなわないので、そこはドラゴンと、一緒に、協力して戦うことになります。で、どのようにこう戦闘に協力するのか、どのように、サポートするのかというところが、そういう戦略を組むのが非常に重要になってきます。
Yeah, just seeing as I said at the top, large scale enemies, that is one of the biggestpoints and sort of pillars of this game. And so obviously Drew is going to, being small against a mantis creature like this one that we're seeing here, he's going to have to work together with Tuban. But that doesn't mean that we don't have any small or mid-sized scale enemies. Drew can very much take on maybe human-sized soldiers or other enemies, but it's really going to be how well you coordinate, how well you team up with Tuban in order to defeat large-scale enemies.
So I'm a big Godzilla and Kaiju fan. So seeing a giant mantis creature is like, oh my god, sugoi.
But you've never really been in the middle of that fight, though.
No, and I've never had like my own like Godzilla to like command and tell me to go and take care of these guys. So you said you were really into dragons. Are you also a Kaiju fan?
ドラゴンだけではなくて怪獣もですか、
うん、そうですね、やっぱり子供の頃から、まあ、今お話に出たゴジラやあとウルトラマンとか、うん、まあやっぱりその巨大なもの同士が戦う絵っていうのは子供の頃から憧れだったので、まあ、ぜひそれをゲームの中でも表現してみたいなっていうのはずっと思ってました。
We've got a desk at work just for his kaiju toys. No joke. Like there's like more Pacific Rim toys next to our main play area than anything else.
Yeah, I grew up falling in love with not just Godzilla like you said, but with Ultraman and anything of large scale. Yeah.
JP, can you speak to what we're seeing here? We've defeated the mantis creature, now we're going into, is it its lair?
So no, actually in this segment of the game we're actually headed towards one of the dungeons in the game, and it's called the Shrine of the Great Tree. So we're inside this tree that's been warped by what we're calling the Pulse, and the Pulse is this energy that goes through Draconis, and it powers the bond between Drew and Tuban, but it also creates a landscape, so you can kind of see like how everything is twisted. That's the Pulse flowing through the environments and twisting them, and what we really wanted to do with Draconis is make it feel familiar, right? So you've been in a forest, you know, kind of the lush greens and the shadow and light playing off of each other, but then when you look at the details you can tell that things are different, kind of like those flowers are totally weird, like you'd never see those on Earth. We want Draconis to be that world where you feel at home, but then you feel alien. And it kind of also speaks to the isolation and personality of Drew.
So you mentioned dungeons. Is there dungeon crawling in this game, or at least dungeon exploring? And is there an open world? I guess I'm just trying to get a piece of like what is the scope of the game?
Open world is dungeon, is dungeon level に網羅されてるんでしょうか。
そうですね、まあ、人間だけじゃなくてドラゴンと一緒に、こう冒険をする世界なので、それに見合った広さの世界というのは用意しています。で、当然今のようにこう野原に出てくる敵だけではなくて、ダンジョンの中にはもっと凶悪なモンスターも潜んでいます。
Yeah, so obviously, because we just talked about these large scale enemies and you partnering up with the dragon, the world that we are illustrating for or setting up for Draconis is large enough for these creatures, for these monsters to not just have survived, but have lived for as long as they have. So it's quite large. And on top of that, Drew will have to find his way to the dungeon where we're headed right now. The dungeons have sort of different types of obviously sort of special enemies that we've prepared especially for this areas.
So yeah, Gamescom, we announced that we're doing four-player cooperative multiplayer with Scalebound. So if you see how big our dragons are already, just imagine the size of the world that you need to have four dragons adventuring together and taking down enemies.
Is it an open world style game where you're taking on quests and then maybe there are side quests, or is it a linear experience where this is what you need to do next and then do this and then do this?
Open world and quests or the things that are やるか、まあ、一本線のような一本道のようなゲームなんでしょうか。
そうですね、まあ、この世界が広いのでいろんなこう冒険があると思うんですけれども、この僕はドルーというキャラクターとこのトゥバンというドラゴンの、キャラクターがとても好きで、2人の絆の物語というものを、描きたいという気持ちが強くあるので、その辺のストーリーはしっかり描いていきたいなと思っています。
So there's obviously a lot of exploration in this worldSo in that sense, there's going to be a variety of ways and paths that you can navigate. But at its core, I guess, sort of the foundation of the story is laid out in a way that Drew, when you meet him for the first time, to by the end of the story, there's a very special building the relationship, the bond sort of evolution taking place. So there is a main story that the player will be following.
I wanted to see them take on that giant monster.
Oh man, it's really cool.
You're leaving me hanging there.
We got to tease something, right?
Yeah. Scalebound looks really cool. Is there a release window for this game yet?
So right now we announced at the Xbox briefing the other day that we are going to release in holiday 2016.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming by the show this morning. Scalebound looks really cool. Have a great rest of Gamescom.
Thank you
so much.
Stay tuned. We have much more to show you here at IGN Live from Gamescom right after this.